So I see in Notion a lot of questions about how to handle projects and tasks. So I've set up this template that you can download. If you don't see the link wherever you're watching this video, over at notiontips.com. But the way I do it, the way I like to do it in general with Notion is fewer databases, I think, is better. If you have a lot of stuff in one database, it's easier to filter and sort and do different kind of linked views than it is to have a bunch of separate databases that you have to try to tie together and doesn't work as well. So for all your projects and tasks, I would recommend just two databases, one for tasks, one for projects. So I'll walk you through this template and show you how I have it and show you a few little tips in here. So the projects database is pretty simple. We just have three projects in here. We have Coca-Cola, Delta, and Home Depot. This is just set up as a gallery view. You could have it as any kind of view you want. I tend to have relatively few projects in Notion, so I can do it like this, but be more effective, space saving if you did as a chart, but however you want to do it. And then in each one, obviously I have the logo here, so you can see the small view in other places than the big view at the top, so it pulls to the gallery. But that's all there is to it. It has the related to the tasks thing that it puts in automatically. That's the only field I have in here. You could perhaps add more. Where I put some more data for them is in a little template I have. So inside here, you can click on New Project Template. It's going to lay out the template, and this just does three things. It gives you a place to put project details, a place to put the project URL. In our case, we're a web shop, so we have the URL we use. And then it pulls in all the tasks for that project. Now, when you add the template in here, it doesn't necessarily pull the right one. So you have to then quick change the filter to the project. For this one is Coca-Cola. You just change it once. And now whenever you pull up the Coca-Cola project, you can see details, big opportunity for us, whatever you want to do. You can put in their website address. You can add other fields here. You can do it as other properties if you wanted, different ways you can do it. But the cool thing is this is all you're going to need for the Coca-Cola project. Now, we can open this as a page so we can view it better and just kind of look at this project all in one place. And what's neat now with this filtered view down here, this filtered linked database, it's a linked database, and then I filter it again. Status is not completed, and we'll talk about that in a minute, and project is Coca-Cola. So when you add a new task right in here, it's automatically going to assign it to Coca-Cola because it's inside of a filtered view. So if you ever have a filtered database view anywhere, and you add a new item there, it's going to inherit that filter, which is great. So we can say for Coca-Cola, we want to do a taste test. We want to do that. It's going to be an open task and it's due the 16th, we'll put it there. So any new task you add is like that. And so again, if we open this, it automatically put it in the Coca-Cola project. And of course you could do a template in here if you wanted for each task. I don't usually do that, but that's something you could do if you wanted. So for the statuses though, I want to show this. The way I do statuses is not as checkboxes, because the problem Notion has that some people think they'll fix eventually and some people think they may not ever fix. I may not see it as broken to fix, is recurring tasks. So I have every task can have one of three statuses: open, completed, or recurring. So if it's open and you finish it, it becomes completed. But if it's recurring and you finish it, you hopefully will trigger your brain to just change the date to the next instance of it. And it's worked well for me. It took me a little while to get used to it. But if I see recurring there, I don't change the status. I just change the date. If I see it's open, I make it close. So we'll talk more about that in a sec. So let's go out here. That's the templates again. So we want to finish setting these up. So Delta I'd set up in here. So let's go ahead and add that template. Again, you could fill in the pieces here. Let's update this filter, which is in this case already set because that was kind of the default in my template. Then we'll go out here to Home Depot. Same deal. Add that new project template and then change the filter to project contains Home Depot. And so now we see all the stuff here. So here's an example of a recurring one. So if I were to do this, if this came up today, I could say, okay, it's done. Now let me just change the date. In my case, it's often weekly things. I just slide down to the next, wherever the blue is, just go down a week from there and make it the 12th. So where this gets neat though with all this stuff is because you have all the tasks in one place, you can certainly go in here and look at what you have in each project, but that's not efficient. The thing I always want in a task management system is to be able to say, what do I need to do today? Across all my projects, everything going on, what do I need to do today? Let's focus on that. So there's a few ways we can do that. So if we go back here, we can go back into our task template database. I set up a few views in here. So you have all tasks, which just list all your tasks. And again, here's why I like to have little icons in there so you can see those in here. I think it's kind of neat. Here's all the tasks, I have everything. Not super helpful because this also will show closed ones. So if we had finished that taste test, marked it complete, it's still going to show up in here. Just a view for everything if you wanted it. The open and recurring tasks. So this is a little more useful. It hides the ones that are completed. So it's just a filter on here that says status is not completed. And then I sort it. So it's the due date, newest is at the top. And then if they're the same, then it sorts by name. The one that really matters is due tasks. And so what this is a filter that says, If the due date for it is on or before today, show it in this list. So this is my page here. If this is a task that's due today or was due in the past and I haven't gotten to it, here's where I need to work on that. Now, even better, because Notion lets you link databases to other places, we could come view this thing every day. And I used to do that with mine, but I actually moved it to my Notion home screen. I had a little linked database that just pulls in all my tasks from whatever projects that are due today. So what I would do in here, perhaps, is on our main template page, we can get to the tasks or projects. Let's just show what's due today. So we can add a linked database. And so we'll pull from the template tasks. That's the name of that database. Okay, now it's just going to pull everything in. So now we can filter a little bit. So let's filter and say, only show me tasks where the due date is on or before today. And so that cuts it down to what we need. And now, I mean, now we can just go with it here. We can have this every day, just pull this up and see what we need to do and take care of it. So in my case, if I came in here and said, ooh, update special on the website, Home Depot, okay, go off and do that, come back. I want to take care of it, and I usually put the status close to the date so I can see them together. You can do however you want. It's like, great, that's done, so let me mark it as complete. Oh, it's a recurring task. Oh, yeah, because I could do that every week. So let's just mark it for the 12th, and now it goes away because it's no longer due on or before today. So now I can work on the next one, create a new logo for Coca-Cola. So no big deal there. Let's go get to work on that one. And in my case, depends how your workflow is, how your boss is, whatever, but I'll say, you know what? It's late in the day here. I'm not going to get to it today. And I know tomorrow's slammed, I'll get to it Monday, so let me just redate it for Monday, and it gets out of my way. So again, I can focus on what I need to today, knowing that on Monday, it'll automatically come back up where I need to see it. So that's a simple way to handle projects and tasks. It works very well. Again, you can pull this linked view other places. You know, again, I pull it on my main little Notion home screen, so I can see all that stuff there. It handles recurring tasks in a simple but kind of archaic way, but does the job pretty well for me, and hopefully this will work well for you. So again, you can grab this template, add it to your Notion over at notiontips.com. And if you have any thoughts or suggestions to make it better, please let me know. Thanks.